Royal Ballet School is a classical ballet school that's been going for almost 100 years, training young dancers to try and be professionals in kind of companies all over the world. What we're looking to do is train dancers that are versatile enough to be able to perform within the kind of modern constraints of dance. So as part of that, we have our healthcare team, which looks to kind of holistically support the dancers while they undertake this training.
So my research hopes to show that in a very packed and congested training schedule that we have here at the Royal Ballet School, we can show that greater frequency of strength training has beneficial elements to the dancers, and one, increases their performance, but also gives them extra level of kind of protection and injury reduction. So making them more available, making them better performers, and making them better in their performance on stage and in the studio. So one of the strength and conditioning group sessions at the Royal Ballet School will be mainly focused around performance enhancement while including fundamental movement skills, so trying to tick off all the key movements that all the dancers can produce, and then looking at kind of physical literacy, so how well are they moving, and then trying to progressively overload, so pushing them week in, week out, that hopefully will then give them that strength increase, but also that ability to transfer that to the studio, to the stage, and so they can perform to the best of their abilities. So this research is really exciting because it's kind of the first time it's ever been done in a kind of elite pre-professional ballet context. So it's really exciting to be kind of at the forefront of that research, but also it's exciting in that the frequency of training, which is what I'm kind of looking at in the PhD, that really hasn't been done too many times in an applied performance setting. So it really will be the first time that that's been done in a kind of meaningful way, and to the extent that we're looking to do it. So on both fronts, it's really exciting.
The Royal Ballet School have always done a fantastic job of profiling their dancers. But what this project is looking at in particular is how that profile changes over the course of the academic year. And as a consequence of that, that's going to help them to optimize the strategies that they put in place in order to enhance performance and to further support well-being with the dancers. This work will give the university the opportunity to support an elite organization like the Royal Ballet School, and as a consequence of that, result in world-class research.
So this research hopefully could mean that going forward in ballet, that physical training, you know, strength and conditioning training, which is still very new and still in the early days within the ballet field, becomes more established, but also starts to grow and become more implemented in kind of the overall daily and weekly training schedule to, again, hopefully improve performance and lessen that injury burden on the dancer's part.
An exciting part of this project is to support Jamie through this experience and to develop the skills needed in order to be able to excel as a coach or a practitioner in the field of strength and conditioning.
So I know the university is really trying to build connections and bridges with elite organisations all across the UK and abroad, and so it's a privilege to be part of that first kind of start of that journey here at the Royal Ballet School. And I think the University of Essex as a whole has been really supportive so far in kind of starting that research process, as well as my supervisors, Lewis Howe and Jamie Talent, have been instrumental in everything that's gone on so far, and I'm sure going forward.